Well, I thought it might be kind of fun to show you how to work with scientific notation and perform some simple calculations, and in particular, convert from one unit of measurement into another. Remember throughout the tour how we were showing you the distances to things in terms of kilometers, then in astronomical units, then in parsecs and light years, all kinds of stuff. Well, it turns out it's really not that hard to calculate with this stuff once you get the hang of it. Now, if you're thinking, hey, I don't like the math so much, I gotcha, I totally understand. And I tell you what right now, if you hang with me through the rest of these videos, I will show you a picture of one of my cats. It's the least I can do. Okay, so let's talk about some general stuff concerning scientific notation. You might remember the whole format that we're using. In other words, if I were to write out 1 million, well, longhand, it's 1 followed by 6 zeros, and in scientific notation, it's simply 10 raised to the 6th power. So what we're saying is this 10 to the 6th, really it's the same thing as saying 1 times 10 to the 6th. The main thing here is that we have a 1, and it's followed by 6 digits, or in this case, 6 zeros. Let's think a little bit about the format for scientific notation. This number 1 is our multiplier. So this multiplier, which I'll just abbreviate with the lowercase letter m, we want to keep that value somewhere between 1, and it can be greater than or equal to 1, but we always want it to be less than 10. And then everything else will be handled by our power of 10, which will do the heavy lifting for us. It will take care of the rest of the big number here. So now let's start to think a little bit about other numbers. Suppose we had 4 million. Well, cool. Now that's 4 times 10 to the 6. But if we had 4.5 million, well, now we have, again, 4. Remember, we want this multiplier down here, to be less than 10 or greater than or equal to 1. So we don't want this to be 4.45. We want this to be 4.5, and then we're going to allow the power of 10 to take care of the rest of the digits after our multiplier. And if you're having trouble with this idea of why we're using a decimal point, just think of it this way. We can say this number in English as 4,500,000, or we could say 4.5 million, and they mean exactly the same thing. That's where this 4.5 fits into the picture. Now, the cool thing about this is that we can get even more specific, and we could even say 4.543 million, right? 4,543,000. So once again, we have our multiplier, which is still going to be greater than or equal to 1, but always less than 10. And we can just simply express the rest of the digits that are not zeros as decimals after the primary multiplier. Again, notice that all of these values are the same power of 10, the same order of magnitude. In all cases, we're talking somewhere in the 10 to the 6th power of 10, or 10 to the 6th range. Okay,